So I cut off his arms and it made him completely impotent. Because if you ever fought Launch Octopus with his arms on, it's a hellish situation. He shoots homing fish everywhere that you can't really dodge. He has a life drain attack where he just creates a giant whirlpool of death. And if you go in the middle, then he'll just absorb all of your life. Literally, like, he'll drain your life and replenish his own until you stop, until you escape. So, there's another thing. I had to kill Launch Octopus before I killed this guy, because if I didn't, this cavern wouldn't be flooded with water. I'm not sure how that happened, but it happened. So that's how I get that. And I go up here, and I gotta fight this ridiculous-ass mini-boss to get the armor upgrade. And it's gonna take a long time, so take a break. Hopefully I kill this guy without taking too much damage, but it doesn't really matter. This stage is pretty easy. I mean, I'm gonna spend like two thirds of my time trying to kill this guy, because I can't figure out if he has a weakness. I've used every weapon that I have on him, and it still takes like forever to kill. I mean, you've seen all the other mini bosses I've killed so far. I kill him in like two hits from some bullshit. I'm not dodging very well, but I don't give a shit. I just want this guy to die. You gotta shoot him right in his head. And that's pretty much it. But if he is using like his screw attack where he shoots out his arm, you can shoot him in the chest. That apparently is all that's happening. So he's just deflecting bullets that you hit him in the arms. And he's smoking, which is clearly a sign that he's very uncomfortable. He's hot and sweaty in there. He's about to quit this job. It's bullshit. Aww. He's dead. Now the final unlockable chamber, new type of body armor, which if you remember from the opening cutscene, it said that his skin would, like the armor plating on his skin would deflect 93% of damage. I'm not sure what that's relative to. I would assume, I don't know, maybe humans, maybe other robots, who knows. So 93% of damage is repelled from his robotic armor. Now this armor, you know, because he's not really fighting any typical types of enemies. He's just fighting other robots. So with this body armor, it's decreased the damage by another 50. So I don't know. I guess he'd be deflecting 97% of damage, but still, when you fight Sigma at the end of the game, he takes out like half your life in one hit. So that guy's a total beast. So I'm riding this armor like a boss, just destroying everything in my path in one hit. Which, yeah, that's something I was talking about that I never really got to explain. Oh, by the way, check this out. This is going to be fun, because if you can get this pattern down, you can kill this guy in like 10 seconds and not take any damage. And you don't even have to dash. You can just walk around. Watch this shit. Smack. 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 And you rinse and repeat until he's dead. Oh god, it's a hard boss. But if you don't have that ability, then he goes up there, shoots a bunch of shit at you, or drops spikes from the ceiling, just do a little bit of damage, and then he disappears. He cloaks behind the wall and then comes back, and you can't hit him until he comes back. Which, I hate bosses like that turn themselves invincible, because they take too long to fucking kill. I just want to shoot him real fucking hard and fast, you know? Pisses me off. This cool little cutscene, where I meet Zero. Zero has been doing absolutely nothing this entire time, but he did discover where Sigma is. He didn't do anything about it, he just discovered where he is. And there's Sigma's big-ass mug. So now we're going into Sigma stage. Finally, Zero is going to be doing something useful. Or is he? I guess we'll have to find out. in about 45 seconds when I see him die. Which would be a spoiler, but it's fucking 1993. Time to grow up, people. This thing is kind of cool. Is, Zero was made by, was like, when they were designing Mega Man X, they're like, okay, we're probably not going to make any more Mega Man games. People are getting tired of the NES. It's old as shit. We should probably start packing it up and start making SNES games. And so they're like, okay. So they brought everybody to make Mega Man X. And Keiji Inafune, or NF King, as he'd been known up to this point, charging this up, because when you're using this ability, you're completely invincible for a few seconds, and you can still shoot, which is pretty awesome. Now, unlike Mega Man, the original Mega Man games, Mega Man X, in between every stage, you recharge all of your weapon energy. So you don't have to worry about conserving shit. Just go all out. As long as you know what weapons you need to use for the stage, and you don't, you know, waste them, then go nuts. Doesn't matter. So what was all that crazy ruckus? Let's find out. He kicked his ass and put him in a cage. Now here's the thing that's kind of crazy. At the beginning of this game, you got your ass kicked by Vile because you're weak and impotent, and he has a crazy power armor, so he's super strong, and you can't beat him, right? Zero comes out and just fucking blasts his arm off in one shot. Not even a fully charged shot. And so Vile runs a stare like a bitch. And so you're supposed to, like, you're supposed to play this game, you're supposed to get stronger, and you can ascend to the strength that Zero has, right? But no matter how much fucking upgrades you find, you still can't do damage to this asshole. You still need Zero to fucking self-destruct to destroy that fucking armor. God. Why couldn't you just build more armor like that? You would control the universe. Yeah. So he's being cocky. He's laughing his balls off with a sweet arm cannon. And I get all of my energy back for no reason. I mean, it would have been hard enough to just break through that barrier, but I got all my energy back too. So now I get to fight him, mano a mano. But he's total pushover. He's running around like a douche. But he is fast. And fast is pretty dangerous. So he has that. All you gotta do is avoid those little arm cannon things, because they make you completely immobile, and he gets to punch you in the face. So he's dead, we're never gonna see him again. Or will we? No, we won't. So now this would be the sweet scene where Zero says, oh man, you're pretty badass, but I'm totally gonna die, so I'm gonna give you my arm cannon and go kill Sigma. But now, since I have the arm cannon already, he's like, oh man, I'm gonna die. Bye. And then he dies. And then we never see Zero again. So, I'm gonna use that because it's totally easy. And I'm probably totally gonna fuck this up. Because this part's kind of complicated. All these fucking assholes in a way. And I hate them. But luckily, since I have the... Fuck. I'm an idiot. Alright. Let's try this again. There we go. Progress. That took way more energy and way more time than I was hoping. So now I get to fight Boomer Kawinger, who is completely rebuilt, apparently. So this is his weakness, which isn't much different than fighting him the normal way, except that you don't have to get to eye level. You just hang a bear like a douche and just kill him from afar with homing missiles. He also seems to get way more aggressive than he normally does. Like, the enemies change tactics if you're using a special weapon on them. Which is neat. I like the idea that it's kind of different. I mean, usually it's easier, but sometimes it's harder. Sometimes it's weirder. Because they get pissed off. They get stressed out. And they get, what is it? Like, when you back them into a corner, they start getting desperate. There we go. Full health. Now I can take on this guy with complete confidence. Now this battle is kind of weird, but I like the idea. It's a change of pace. Now you see all these little strands? You remember like those puzzles where like they have the strands and like the object will go across all the strands and only where a strand is, and otherwise they won't change paths. Like they have to change paths if one is available. That's what's going on here. So you see for a second all of the paths that he's going to take, but you have to map it out in your mind where he's going to go. And the more damage you do to him, the smaller that window is for you to map it out in your brain. And I'm not sure, but I'm pretty sure you're just all completely random. So sometimes it's really easy, sometimes it's not so easy. And I've had times where I've had to use the E-Tank because just keep fucking it up. He's going too fast. It's too complicated for me. But if you're good at one of those puzzles, which I'm probably not really, I just kind of take little obvious steps. I can usually get like halfway through it before it just becomes before it becomes wild guessing. Then you probably kill this guy no problem. But the worst part is that when he gets to the ground, there's like a half a second that his eye is open where he's vulnerable, and then he goes right back up to the top. And so if you get hit, then you're stunned longer than the amount of time, then he's weak, so you can't hit him. Which sucks. Because it never gets any easier. Now we're going on to stage two. I'm going to use these things, because I'm never going to need them again for the whole rest of the game. There's no more bosses in the game that are weak against them. But there's a lot of enemies in this level, at least right now, that are in hard-to-reach places. So I'm gonna take them out real quick and be done with it. That's why that ability is awesome. So I'm gonna pull out fire and torch the shit out of this asshole. So you just sit here, wail on him, and you only have to move when that happens. When he deflects it, and you know he's about to charge dash your ass. Other than that, no worries. I mean, look how much damage it does. It's like 4 or 5 lines. I've never counted. How many lines are there in a full health bar for one of these assholes? I don't know. And I don't think it changes for the other X games either. But, I never knew. Just kind of gauge it. So I'm going to run through the rest of this level. At least this little section. On mobile suit armor. Totally killing it. These guys don't even have a chance. The best part is you just get through and not take any damage. So a full life bar ready for the next two bosses. Now, I don't remember my time with the original Mega Man too much, but if I recall correctly, it was a lot like this. Like, this game feels a lot like a remake, like a straight, complete, total remake of the original Mega Man. Which isn't to say that it's bad, because Mega Man 1, I feel, is pretty fucking bad. It's just, it's not really, well, not really bad, but just, it's so rough around the edges that, it's inferior in every way to all the other games that came after it. However, all the things that he did with this game, pretty fucking awesome. And if I remember correctly, Mega Man 1 was the only one where when you got to the Wily stages, you had the boss rush. And the bosses weren't just in their own little capsules and you just fought them individually. You just, you know, took your time, kill them all straight in a row. This game, like the, you know, the other Mega Man X games, it's just like that, where they're all in capsules, and you just kill them at your leisure, in your own, in the own order that you want to do. But in Mega Man X 1, like Mega Man 1, they just have regular Sigma stages, just like the Wily stages, and they're all integrated into them. And you just have to kill them just like normal mini-bosses. Which by then shouldn't be a problem, because you have all of your upgrades, you're totally a boss, and you just kill it. And you have all, and you have their weaknesses. So, you have nothing to worry about, really. By the way, if it wasn't completely obvious, don't fall down and hit the inspection floor, or you will die. Which usually I try not to kill the nose first, because if you kill the nose first, then those doors will stay open and you won't be able to dodge on the other parts. You'll just be completely vulnerable, basically. So you want to kill the eyes first. But I didn't give a shit. I had the advantage, so I was cool.